don't know too much about all these reality judge shows, you know, not judge legal shows, but I'm talking about where they take a profession and then they have somebody, they have about three or four people sit there on a panel and give criticism to whatever this craft or talent is.
Even if they're just mildly successful in that profession.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, that's why you need it, man.
C-list, D-list.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
You F-list. Gotta,
yeah.
The first season, you start off with A-list, and by the time you get to season seven, yeah, you're down to D-list.
Tommy and I were talking about this earlier. They do it now with food. They do it with
furniture.
They do it with furniture. They do it with doing special effects. I mean, everybody's jumping on that formula where they're making money by having that judgment criticize whatever you talent thing. Yeah. And for the most part, I'm not complaining too much because they've gotten more civil. You know,
plus, if this goes away, that's what we're going to be doing next.
Yeah, you know, shit, when that goes away, hell, we still might be doing this. Right. Oh, yeah, we still talk. Yeah.
We're at the A-list right now.
Ah, yes, right. We can only go down. But one of the things I can say about it, Simon Cowell, you might call him an asshole, but he was brutally honest. After him, everybody just said, you know what? You can't be Simon Cowell. I'm just going to come in, and I'm going to be honest, but I'm not going to try to come down on people that hard.
Yeah.
Not everybody can be Simon Cowell.
Simon Cowell is one of those rare exceptions. And I work for a guy like this who could be, like, as a boss, he could be like Kevin Spacey. He would just ream you out in front of everybody. And the thing that would make you the most mad was that he'd be right about everything
he'd
he said.
He'd be right.
And like, yeah, I'd like to tell him to fuck off, but he ain't said nothing wrong.
When Simon Cowell looks at you and says, you're horrible, I mean, you might take it as, that guy's
you don't
asshole.
Know.
Yeah, you don't know me. But you know what? He saved you some time.
Yeah, he did. You a saved, life. He saved you a life.
You say it crushed your dreams. I say he saved you some time.
Yeah.
So when you look at these people and you say, damn, they're worse than Simon Cowell, they got to be bad. Have you heard about this, Mark?
Yeah, I saw the video.
Yeah.
Right before I left work, because people kept talking about it so much. I was like, all right, let me go ahead and watch this.
How'd it make you feel?
Yeah.
I think all these shows are pretty dumb to begin with.
Yeah.
And seeing that, I was like, had it not all been all this controversy, I just figured, like, okay, this is part of the put on.
Yeah. But even if this is a put on, it's bad. Yeah. I don't watch a lot of these shows, like I said, so I know nothing about the X Factor, especially the one in New Zealand.
But apparently,
I didn't even know they had an X Factor in New Zealand.
They had TV in New Zealand.
I thought they just had hobbits in New Zealand. But
it's on the other side of the world, so it's more of a Y Factor at that point.
Now, I look at this and I say, well, whatever y'all got over there, it's pretty bad because y'all have some real assholes talking to people. And a lot of people say, hey, look, they ain't all of us. As you can see what happened.
Ain't most of them.
Ain't most of them. As you can see what happened after this incident right here. Two people on the panel of the X Factor there decided to talk about this guy and went way above and beyond just average criticism. I don't know what the hell this is, but
damn. Chill,
ladies and gentlemen, I'm just going to state the obvious. We have a doppelganger in our midst. I, as an artist who respects creative integrity and intellectual property, I am disgusted at how much you have copied my husband. From the hair to the suit, do you not have any value or respect for originality?
Now, the girl you hear talking is Natalia Kills, and you're like, who the fuck is that?
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah,
who's the guy that she's talking to?
Irvine something?
John, is it John Irvine?
Yeah, something like that.
I'll find his name right here. Yeah, this is a contestant that came out and he's sang. And they're not even talking about his musical talent.
No, not at all.
Let me see who this guy is. I got him right here. His name is, let me see here. It is John, I think it's John Irvine. Let me see. Yeah, Joe Irvine.
Yeah.
Joe Irvine. They're not talking about his music. They're not talking about his musical talent. They're talking about how he's dressed. And she's offended because she feels like he copied her husband, a guy named Willy Moon. Who is that? Exactly.
You're a laughing stock. It's cheesy.
But
it's disgusting.
Copy Cleopatra?
I personally found it absolutely artistically atrocious. I am embarrassed to be sitting here in your presence, having to even dignify you with an answer of my opinion.
What's funny is that she thinks that they're booing him.
Yeah, she does.
She didn't realize they're booing her.
Yeah, she's totally oblivious. And that's why she keeps going. She's like, yeah. They know what I'm saying. They know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, Yeah, Joe.
Thank you, Natalia. You're beautiful.
To me, it just feels a little bit cheap and absurd.
Now, here's the thing.
It's a little bit cheap and absurd. Yeah.
You look at this dude, Joe Irvine, man. He's been cool for the most part.
Yeah.
But you can see right here.
He looks like he wants to cry.
He looks like I want to knock the fuck out of that bitch right now. He looks like he wants to jump right over this table and just slap the fuck out of her.
God damn.
Pull some Street Fighter shit over
here. Hell yeah.
Bitch, who you talking to? And if he had done it, and you can look at his expression, he's like, I want to beat the fuck out of this bitch.
At first it looked like he wanted to cry.
Yeah,
and then it looked like he wanted to be.
The more she went on, because first
her talking, he looked like he wanted to cry. When that dude's like,
say something about the fight.
Well, you know, that's the thing. He's sitting up there being all cool, and the first looked like he wanted to cry, and then and even then, I think like, all right, he's thinking, I ain't gonna worry about this. I mean, this is a joke. He's sitting up there waiting on a punchline.
He
right
is.
Now.
Yeah. This whole time, I think he feels like the whole thing is a joke.
Yeah. And it gets to a point where he realized this bitch is still going.
Yeah.
He's like, this shit ain't funny no more. Like, wait a minute.
I think that's serious.
Wait a minute. Shit, joke's over now. Wait, what the fuck is going on here? And the thing that I think really got to him and let him know that this was real is when the husband, Mr. Moon over here, started chiming in.
You're like, it's like Norman Bates dressing up in his mother's clothing. It's just a little bit creepy. Yeah, and I feel like you're going to stitch someone's skin to your face. And then
he's looking like, this is a woman right here. You, I can beat the fuck out of you. He really like, don't let this little frame fool you right here. don't let this nice guy image, don't think I won't come in there and slap the fuck out of you. And you know what? I want you to listen to this dude, because this is what made me so mad. There's nothing like, well, arrogant, yes, Tommy, but there's nothing like British arrogance.
Yeah.
Because they have that accent. They can just rub it in because they draw everything out. You look like someone who skinned somebody. You're going to wear their skin and kill everyone in the room. Fuck you.
Just to be like
Bates dressing up in his mother's clothing. It's just a little bit creepy, and I feel like you're going to stitch someone's skin to you.
Who's that motherfucker on Harry Potter? The blonde-haired
Malfoy.
Kid. Malfoy. Malfoy. That's some Malfoy shit.
It is some Malfoy.
You know what I'm saying? Potter. You know, I hate that.
Both of them are like villains from
Harry Potter.
Jupiter Ascending.
They really are. Jupiter, you think you're the queen of the universe. You know,
these motherfuckers, they look like some straight up villains.
They do.
They really
do. You think you can win this contest? Man, they do. They copy me. They look like some straight up cartoon villains right there.
They do.
They look like they should be chasing Bullwinkle and Rocket. These motherfuckers here, man. I mean, you just waiting for this guy to end up to say, fuck you, Potter. Ain't nothing like that old sleazy,
well, the thing this is, little
sleazy British shit.
Yeah.
This whole, like, you're copying my husband's, like, he does not have the patent on suits and slicking your hair back. I'm sorry.
If that's the case, your husband's copying Justin Timberlake.
Neither one of them do. Neither one of them. Now you know what? The girl?
Yeah.
I'll kind of give it to her. Now, I look at her, and I'm going to be honest, I'm not even trying to be mean. This bitch is so orange, I thought she was a transvestite. I didn't even think she was a woman.
Man, you can say what you want. That girl is fine.
She kind of looked like an Oompa Loompa.
She looks, really looked at thank her you. For a second. She looks like a cross between Cleopatra and an Oompa Loompa right there, man.
You say what you want to say.
Yeah, I'm with Martin.
That girl's gorgeous.
She's on the outside. Anyway. Hey, inside, she's shit.
Hey, look.
On the outside, she'll look half bad.
When you that fucking orange, I see that only one place. Sesame Street, The Muppet Show, and drag shows. What you doing at drag shows, Corey? That ain't the point. But
slow me down a second.
You know, okay. Wow. Well, when she starts beating, well, you know what I was going to say. Let me think about this. Damn, it just sunk in, you know?
Yeah,
like, she can criticize me while we're in the middle of it. I was like, I don't care.
I'm not going to call in the morning. You know,
right.
Yeah, but, yeah.
I had to really think about this and say, you know, of all the things I've stuck my penis into, I had to call bullshit on this. Yeah, she's all right. You know.
You go home with that in a second. What are you talking about?
I mean, she's like a younger, hotter Salma Hayek right there.
Yeah.
You know what? We're still fucking, man.
Yeah.
She looks like a cross.
She's a piece of shit. No doubt.
She's a piece of shit. I'll fuck the shit out of her.
Yeah, you know, same here.
And you know what? I'm glad she's like that. That make me feel good about not calling her back the next day. Fuck you, bitch. You didn't deserve me.
Yeah.
You know, that's the kind of shit you want to have sex with and just leave her.
I deserve that, but you don't deserve me.
It's good for Orange. I mean, that's racist, man. What's wrong with no Orange?
Yeah, what's wrong? You don't like Dreams? Yeah, yeah, you know what? Shit, I'd fuck the shit out of a fuck. You know, I'm pulling. What am I talking about, man?
You've done that before.
I've done this shit before.
Yeah. You had sex with an Orange person?
Man, me and Captain Kirk, man. Shit, we used to have
green
sex with
bitches,
all
orange
green,
bitches, pink
orange,
bitches.
Purple shit. Yeah, yeah. Shit. Miss Piggy walked in the room right now. I'll fuck the shit out of her, man. Yeah, she's all right. She's all right until she starts getting that attitude.
Until she opens her mouth.
She's still a bitch, but you know what? She's trying to talk about being original. And then people start putting tweets online and they're showing her, like, you talk about originality. You are not original yourself. I mean, they have pictures of her where she looks like, who is that right there?
Amy Winehouse.
Amy Winehouse.
Yeah.
Madonna. Cleopatra. They got Dora the Explorer. And tell me she don't.
No, she does.
She really
That's
does.
Perfect.
Tell me she don't. They
Dora like Dora the Explorer became a teenager and went through a goth phase.
Went through a goth phase, yeah. Yeah.
Well, her parents did abandon her in a South American.
Yeah, you look at Dora. Man, they got the same skin tone and everything. Look at this shit, man.
Oh, holy shit.
Wow.
That's crazy.
Yeah. Yeah. Wow, you were right.
I was as a child.
And she grew up to be a goth kid.
Yeah.
No wonder she's all fucked up.
What Martin says, that's the logical conclusion to where she would end up.
And you know what they even say? That she went through a period, if you read about her, she went through a period where she was stalking her boyfriend, tried to burn the house down that they were living in.
I believe that.
Yeah, yeah.
Because so she was even stealing from Left Eye Lopez.
Yeah. No shit.
So, you know, she's insane.
Yeah, she's fucking crazy. Anyone who goes off on a rant like that is... It's
yeah,
not insane.
It's insane. Yeah. Now, I don't think she has an original style either, so she's being kind of a hypocrite, but at least she stands out. You know, she's doing that Lady Gaga shit, but at least she stands
but
out.
This husband
right Willy. Here. I won't. You know what? Every white 20-something male in the world needs to put a cease and desist on this fool
here. Don't you want
to
tell him, like, hey, man, Rick Astley called. He wants his look back.
Yeah, no shit.
Yeah, look like he's Rick rolling everybody right now. You look at him, you hear, never gonna give you. You know what I mean? You ain't got shit, man, to say. No, anybody. You know, I wish, you said something the day earlier. You know, I wish the corpse of Frank Sinatra would come and slap the fuck out of you, man. You think you, like, what makes you so original?
Right.
Asshole.
It's funny. One of this dude's songs, really, because he really hasn't had a hit. I think the highest number, I mean, you know what?
It's 26. It was 26 on the UK charts.
Oh, damn.
But he has a song that pretty much rips off Kanye West's Jesus Walks. Takes the whole beat
Fuck
of that and
dude,
just does
man.
some production shit over it. And
yeah, these.
Yeah, it's bullshit.
What happened is...
That's original. Right?
I'm sure what they were doing is they were overcompensating. They were trying to actually make a... I don't believe that they're that shitty. I really don't. I believe that they were actually trying to pull a Simon Cowell. They were sitting out there trying to be very critical, and they thought what they were doing was funny, and then it ended up backfiring on them. It ended up backfiring on these two so bad that they fled New Zealand the next day.
If I may be the devil's advocate here. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, Joe Irvine, we haven't seen what he did.
I saw it.
Okay, because I'm like, he could have been terrible.
Well, even if he was terrible, they didn't focus on his music.
No. But the other thing is, with all these reality
shows...
You
suck as a lawyer.
With all these reality shows, everybody... has a producer standing there saying, hey, it'd be really great if you do this. Yeah. We'll give you a close-up if you say something like this. Okay, this guy's going to come out. Be as mean as you can. It's going to be good ratings.
They didn't tell them that. They brought them on because I guess they were kind of eccentric.
The ratings were slipping.
And the ratings were slim, but they didn't bring them on to be bullies.
No,
assholes.
I bet you they did. Because having Simon, if you said the ratings are slipping, that's exactly what they want. They want somebody crazy who can be that mean person to get people watching, to go like, what did they say? Now, maybe it went further. Yeah, you know, I think it got more of a reaction they wanted. And the thing that was funny to me that comes right after this is that the blonde chick who's on there, she sees that the crowd is against them, and she works that to her advantage
she
in
does.
A big way.
Big time.
She's like, huh.
She's about to get some fans in this motherfucker.
Oh, no, she does. She does. Let me see here. Yeah,
she's an opportunist.
Hell yeah.
And then kill everybody in the audience. But
okay.
Do you?
I'm going to say it. It's disgusting. You make me sick. It's absolutely disgusting. You have no identity. I can't stand it. I'm ashamed to be here.
Right now, there's a producer talking into the ear of those other two people there, saying, okay, now, here's your chance. Contradict them.
You know, I like the dude sitting next to the blind. He's like, God damn, girl.
He is.
Yeah, he didn't say shit.
He's like, he looks like, was this in a script somewhere? Yeah. The fuck is going on? Because nobody told us. At first, he was trying to be like, but you copy Cleopatra. He's like, let me just shut my fucking mouth and just get on out the way. Martin always believed in that conspiracy shit. He does, I don't believe it.
No, man, if you read anything about reality TV, it's all about that.
Yeah, the shit's fiction.
Like, now, who you want to agree with?
It is.
You're a flip-flopping son of a bitch.
All those guys who like, yeah, I've been out in the woods, the wilderness, and surviving. Camera cuts. They go to a trailer. They chill. They come back out. They shoot some more.
Okay, you know, I don't. Yeah, know.
That is true. I've researched that shit before.
No, you didn't. You researched a goddamn thing. Now you just riding on his bandwagon.
People just assholes on those shows. It's like, yeah, because there's somebody in an earpiece telling them like, say this. You know, let's reshoot this part.
You were right though. This girl, she jumped in there.
She's straight up opportunity.
Like, hell yeah, she's
like, I ain't going down with this secret ship right here. No. Fuck, this is the Titanic, and I'm grabbing a fucking lifeboat right now.
I think I look really good, and
I think you look good because you're dressed as my husband. Actually, you're dressed better than her husband.
Thank you, now.
And she's like, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Look at her. She's like, I'm going to be trending in about 30
minutes. Yeah, right.
Yeah. Yeah. Hashtag good guy. Right? Yeah.
Good man.
Actually, Mel needs glasses.
I'm not being so well behind. Mel?
Do you know what, Joe? I don't think many people have believed in you in your life, but I tell you right now, I believe in you. You've got a beautiful tone. Please, don't listen.
You know, it's funny because 5 minutes before that, she had written, sounds like shit. Uh-huh. And then when she went off, she was like, I really believe in you.
And you saw how that host was quick to go like, hey, no, I'm sorry, Mel, you go ahead and tell him how you feel.
And see, look, I even looked up like what the dude did, and mm-hmm. you know what Willie Moon, you know, his shit, which I told you his shit was it's shit. If I can use that word.
Yeah,
enough.
Yeah.
But the dude, no, he did like a Michael Bublé type set, you know.
Ugh. You talking about Joe Irvine?
Yeah, this dude. It wasn't great, mm-hmm. but it wasn't horrible.
Michael Bublé ain't great. Imitator is going to be worse.
It was mediocre, but you know, it wasn't horrible. So it was no reason
for them to go off like that. Rather, this is true what Martin is saying. Because if it's true, then they just threw these people under the bus. Yeah. Right?
Well, and you know, and they're probably like they left New Zealand probably because they had already had a date to be somewhere else, but it got spun into like, oh, they fled.
Well, why wouldn't they
can't ever come back?
Yeah,
now.
Why wouldn't they say because they're fired now? They're fired and they fled to New Zealand. Why wouldn't they just say, yeah, this is bullshit. We did what they told us to do, and we get fired.
It's part of the contract. You ever watch wrestling? Because that's all scripted. That's all told.
This is going deep with this shit.
But that's what so much of reality TV is. It is somebody coming and saying, like, we're going to play it this way. We're going to run it this way. You're going to do this. We're going to say this. Just go with it.
Yeah, look, he's not lying about that. That's pretty much all reality TV is. But I think in this case, these are just
like reality TV is reality TV.
Hold on.
Yeah, these are just two fucking
assholes. Excuse me.
Okay, sure.
Hold on, Martin. When you going to suck his dick?
You know, really?
You've been dick riding this motherfucker for the last.
Will you let me finish? Goddamn. He's not lying when he says that, yeah, that shit does happen. But in this case, I don't think that was the case.
Okay, I'm disgusted
to be in the same room with you right now.
Hey, I ain't Joe Irvine. I'll choke your ass.
I ain't Joe Irvine either. Shit.
We'll be two fighting motherfuckers.
We'll be two motherfuckers holding each other. You let go, motherfucker.
Well, actually,
be three motherfuckers.
Be like a Tarantino film.
See, the chat start booing you and cheering for me, so Tommy switch sides.
I read my audience, you know?
All right. Well, shitty people, whether or not they...
I think they were just shitty people.
I think they just kind of shitty people, yeah. You know? Because even then, they probably told them to go off, but not that hard.
No.
You know, I'm sure they told them to be the bad guys, but yeah, not that hard.
Nah, that was them.
Was there ever a point that they talked about his music, though?
No. That's the thing. They never talked about
all.
His music.
Never? Oh,
hey,
okay.
Can I also point out that the girl who supports him and believes in him didn't talk about his music either?
True.
Didn't have to.
Yeah.
Didn't have to.
I wouldn't want to.
Yeah. She didn't need to because this fool already knew. I'm a star after this.
I believe in you, Joe. Yeah.
No matter if that
what you think of my songs? Well, I believe in you, Joe.
No matter if those songs, if the song he did was good or bad, what could she really say?
You know what? Let me put it this way.
There's no way she could even criticize him.
After this, none of this shit matters because he's like... You know what? My career is made.
Yeah, I'm
he's
good.
Like, this is the easiest fucking competition I've been
in. I don't even have to win and I win.
Yeah, he's looking at them. It's a point where he was going to look like he was going to get hurt, but then he's like, nah, y'all keep going.
Yeah.
I'm going to sit here and be, I'm going to shut the fuck up. I'm going to throw in a compliment so I just look like the victim.
Yeah.
You look nice. I thought I'm okay. I thought it was okay. Yeah, all right. You know, he played that shit up.
You're still beautiful.
Yeah, you're still beautiful.
Yeah.
Man, and you know what?
That was classy.
It was.
Everybody here is phony. Everybody is phony.
It's all phony.
Everybody here is phony. All these all these expressions that he's making, he knows what he's doing. All these expressions that he's doing right now, he's like, yeah, okay, look sad. Get the crowd on your side. Let me show my British teeth right now. So, you know, everybody knew how to work this.
Yeah. Man, okay, so I went to the Jimmy Kimmel live show.
I thought you were going to say I went to the gym. I was like, you a goddamn...
I go to the gym. Anyway, went to Jimmy Kimmel.
And do what?
and he had this... he showed this clip that was this viral video of this girl twerking where she twerks up on a door and then...
Oh, we seen that. Everybody
falls backwards into a glass table, sets herself on fire.
Yeah.
You know, went viral, million views. He says, like, but y'all don't see the rest of it. It's him coming out, putting her out with a fire extinguisher.
Yeah, we saw this.
Right. And he talks about how this was all set up by him. He set up the whole thing just to see if he could do something, a fake video that would get all these views. And you're like, okay, so if that's going on, you look at this, that's easy to fake. That is nothing.
Okay. Like the way Martin went through the whole shit. We know. We
I was waiting on something new.
I know. I was like, shit, what's the revelation here?
Well, that
deep shit that's about to be dropped.
You look at how easy it is. Like, they do this all the time. It's nothing new.
All right. All this shit here, this was all scripted.
Yeah, pretty much.
How you like that? We gonna suck his dick line.
That was good.
We rehearsed that all day. Yeah, man. You were really good today, man.
Thank you.
Martin, you could actually.
I know. I'm missing my cues.
Yeah. You haven't memorized your lines at all. You didn't say a fucking thing through this.
I was just trying, man.
Amateur.
I've watched this show way too many times and seen God just keep. I'm just like, I ain't.
See, he learned.
I might throw in like one or two. That's like, hi, I'm still here, you know.
That's like feeding alligators. You're like,
nope. Corey ain't going to be like, God damn it, I said shut up. You ain't got no mic near you. I'll tell you one more time. No,
and then I yell at you, and then you can look like this.
The chat's going to be on my side.
What name? Hey,
hashtag Team Leroy.
What's the chat talk, Team Leroy?
There you go.
What's the chat talking about? How y'all doing in there? Y'all still hanging with us? Somebody said, damn, my stream cut out.
Oh,
I hope the stream is still going. Let me look and see. Well, it's still going on my end.
You must have got a payment.
Well, you talking about conspiracy shit. Somebody said, give Martin a 10-foil hat. Somebody said, Martin, you talked about that video on this show. God damn. All right. Somebody said Double Toasted is all scripted. Martin and Corey don't hang out after the show. Their names are Douglas and Philip. They're Shakespearean actors.